So Joey, we're looking at a range of just pure grid connect inverters here. These are, to me, all new models.
Yes.
This is, what, a 3-6?
Yes, 3-6. And this is, we call it Boost, Boost Series, which is the most popular ones in Australia within our brand. And it's from 3 kW to 6 kW.
What's the boost mean?
Boost means we can boost the power.
Oh, good. So I like the way you've represented the key features, because this is what everyone's going to ask about 10 times.
Yes.
Of course it's IP66, very efficient. Do you know what the efficiency is?
Yeah, it's 99.9%.
Whoa, 99.9.
Yes.
You're kidding me. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Your engineers must be so bored now. Nothing to do. Boss, we're 99.99.
We still have 0.1
to go.
Yeah.
And so it's got a CT and meter. What's that for?
So, because pretty much everyone wants to monitor their system, and usually we use a meter to monitor the, what's going on in the grid, and we also support CT for a cheap option as well.
So, and with this meter or the CT, you can see consumption in the house as well?
Yes.
And you can use it for export limiting?
Yes, correct.
Right, okay. Well, it's pretty much a given these days, export limiting, because of limitations on how much solar you can eject, but it's quite a useful range, really, 3-6.
Yes, yeah. And that's the most popular range in Australia.
And this is pretty small. How much does this weigh?
It's to my record, only weighs 17 kilo.
Right, okay. Yeah. Wow, it's really a one-person job to install.
Yes, yeah, definitely, yes.
Yeah. Well, let's look at the next unit. So, what are we looking at with this unit?
Now we are looking at a smart series, which is 6 to 8 kilowatt range. And we believe this version will be the next most popular ones, because the panels are getting bigger and the customer wants bigger systems. Now we can see a clear change from 5 to 8 kilowatt now.
Yeah,
yeah.
I looked at the stats recently. 8 kilowatts is the average system size now in Australia.
Yes.
So yeah, you're definitely on the money. I'm just looking under the base here. It looks like you've got three inputs, two MPPTs.
Yeah, two MPPTs, three inputs. Because the 6 kilowatt are a little bit overlapped with the Boost series. The main difference is the numbers of inputs. So for the Boost, 6 kilowatt only has two inputs, and for this one we have three inputs.
Right, that's great.
Yeah.
Now there's no DC isolator on this side, it's under here. So you've got an integrated DC isolator, also probably waiting for TÜV to certify it.
Yeah. I think pretty much most of the manufacturers are waiting for the certification yet now.
Yeah, I think by the end of this year a big cheer is going to go up. Everyone will get their DC isolator certified.
Hopefully, yeah.
Now, there's something very exciting behind you. Let's move on to that one. Okay, so Joey, I thought we just looked at the Boost. Is it the Boost?
Yes, similar to Boost, but it's a three-phase inverter. And I believe we made it so compact, it will be the smallest three-phase string inverters in the industry right now.
So there's some amazing optimization in the design to make a 15 kilowatt three-phase inverter that's the same size as your 3 kilowatt single phase.
Yes, exactly, and it's very light. It only weighs 18 kilo.
Yeah.
For a 15 kilowatt.
It must be very efficient then.
Exactly.
Yeah, wow. And it's got two
MPPTs, four inputs.
Three inputs. Am I missing one?
Three inputs.
Yes.
But three inputs, right. Yeah, my bad. Yes, three inputs.
That's okay.
And this one, four inputs, sorry.
Yeah, yeah. We've got so many to remember.
Yeah.
But I guess the take-home message is small, compact, efficient, three-phase. It's got all the usual features you'd expect, including, 200% DC oversizing.
Yes.
That's huge.
Yes, exactly.
So you could put 30 kilowatts of PV on this.
Yes.
My gosh, wow. Okay, if you're if you're allowed to, but yeah, that's pretty impressive. And you've got down here heat pump and EV charge compatible.
Yes. So we need for heat pump, we need an additional adapter for heat pump, and EV charger. Pretty much all of our new products are compatible with our own EV chargers now.
Now, you say heat pump compatible. Does that mean it can talk to the heat pump and run it at the optimum time?
Yes. But it depends on the models of heat pumps.
Yes.
And, yeah.
Is it using like the DRED, demand response enabled device, through DRM?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Wow. That's so cool. Now we've got one more, which is equally impressive. Let's check it out.
Yeah.
So, Joey, we're up to the big boy now.
Yes.
That's not me. That's this.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're calling this the Pro, right?
The Pro. Yes. It's a three-phase, grid connected inverters.
Yep.
And it's not physically big for a 30 kilowatt inverters. 30 kilowatt. Yeah.
I've got a 30 kilowatt inverter in my lab, and it's about that long, and it takes like two people just to get it out of the box.
Yes.
Let alone all. And this, wow, that's incredible.
Yes, it's light and small. Yeah. Very compact. Yeah.
And I believe it's suitable. It says down here for large cell sizes. So it's got six inputs. It's got three MPPTs by
yes,
the look of it?
Three MPPTs.
And how many amps can you do on each MPPT?
32
amps. 32 amps.
Yeah.
So that's 16, 32 amps on each MPPT.
Correct.
Wow, so that really does suit those high current modules now.
Yeah.
Excellent. So shadow tracking's really useful when you've got some partial shading on a module and you want to find where the true MPPT is.
Yes.
So it has to do a rescan every so often to find the global maximum power point as opposed to the local maximum power point. So that's a really nice feature that you generally only see on utility scale products. So really it's bringing some of that high-end smarts.
Yes, now and we made it available pretty much for all of our new models.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Great. Well, Joey, thanks for showing me around the SolaX stand.
Thank you. Thank you.
See ya.
Okay. See ya.